The best way to get a blurry background is to do it on camera, but if you're working with an image you didn't take, the second best way is to use a photo editing software. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a blurry background, also referred to as a shadow depth of field, for any image. For the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to use this photo which I downloaded from unsplash.com. As you can see, this photo was shot with a wide depth of field, so the background is not as blurry as we would want it to be. First, we have to determine what's going to be in focus and what's going to be out of focus. Obviously, the subject is going to be in focus, as well as the area on where she stands. The background will get blurred as the scene gets farther away from the camera. And to simulate this effect, a black to white gradient mask is used. So we first need to make a selection of our subject since she will be in focus, starting with a rough selection using the lasso tool, which I'm going to refine using the quick mask mode. If you would like to use the selection method as well, pick the lasso tool, make a rough selection of your subject, then click on the quick mask icon in the toolbar or press Q on your keyboard. Pick the brush tool, use the options at the top to adjust the brush size and the hardness. Currently my foreground color is black, so whatever area I paint on is removed from the selection. Paint with black to deselect areas or with white to select areas. The red areas are the parts that are not selected. I just want to mention that I'm going to speed this up to save time and actually get you to where you came here to see. You can also skip this part using the timestamps in the description below. If I want to switch to white, I can just press X on the keyboard to swap the foreground and background colors. And I recommend you take your time on your image since selections are really important for achieving the desired result. When finished, click the icon again or press Q to make that into a selection. Now, I'm going to drag a horizontal guide to around here where the girl is standing because I want to keep things in focus there, and I'm going to gradually blur the background until we get here where everything should be blurry. To achieve this effect, I'm going to use two additional layers. So right click the main layer and choose duplicate. We'll remove the background from the copy, so with the current selection active, apply a layer mask. Now make the original layer active and control click the mask on the other layer to bring back the selection. Then go to select, modify, expand. Go with 5 to 10 pixels. This will help us avoid the halos on the edges of the subject. Now go to edit, fill, content aware, OK. If you hide the top layer, you can see the fill. Doesn't look perfect, but that's OK, because we only care about the edges. Now, to create the blur effect, we need to duplicate the background layer, and I'm going to apply a simple black to white gradient mask on this new layer that's going to allow me to get the blur effect. So with the layer active, click the mask icon, then Alt click on it. The mask is now shown on the canvas. Pick the gradient tool. You may need to open the gradient editor if you need to modify it according to your image. Once finished with that, from the top of the document, drag the cursor all the way to the bottom and release. Click on the layers terminal to exit out of mask mode. Hide the subject layer and go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Set the value between 20 to 30 depending on how much blur you want. Then unhide the subject layer and now let's see the before and after. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Thank you for watching and I will talk to you again soon.